Hello everyone, in the previous video we seen like how to insert an element into a max heap. So now in this video we will discuss how to delete a node from a max heap. So here in this example I have taken one max heap and this is the array representation of this max heap. It has 9 elements. So how we can delete an element from a max heap we have to see now. So generally deleting something from max heap means just giving the root node. Okay, that means delete means root node we have to return, then we have to again restructure this heap. Okay, or else if specifically you want to delete some node, that also we can do. Okay, but generally deleting something from max heap or min heap means we have to return the root. Okay, then we have to readjust this heap. So after deleting from the max heap, what we will get? This root. This root is actually the highest value inside this max heap, means the maximum value. Opposite thing is also true for min heap. For min heap, deletion means we will get the root, which is the minimum value present inside the main heap. Okay, so now what procedure we have to follow to delete a node? So the first step is we have to replace the root or element to be deleted with the last element. Suppose I have to delete the root node, so I have to replace this 101 with the last node, which one is 8. Then we have to delete this one from this position, and then when 8 will be placed here, that time we can see this max heap property will be disturbed. It will be not a heap anymore. So we have to again heapify, or this 8 we have to place in the correct position, or we have to traverse from top to bottom to make it in a comfortable position where it will be a max heap again. Okay, so now you will see how the procedures is going. So first thing is we have identified that 101, this root node we have to delete. Okay, so I am taking it aside. Then this node, this last node, I will place in the root. Okay, and this node is deleted from here. Now what will be the array structure? So it will be something like this. Here we can see one empty place because already it has reduced one node. Okay, and this 8 is now in front or in the root position. Okay. Now when 8 came here, after that this is not a max heap anymore, so we need some swap operation to place 8 in the proper position. So we need a swap between 37 and 8 because 37 is greater than 8. Okay, so that's why 37 is greater than 81 also. So there should be a swap between 37 and 8. Okay, now after 8 came here, we have to see like is 8 greater than this 2 child node? No, because 27 can be replaced with 80 to make it a max heap. So again we need a swap between these two. Now 8 is present in the proper position, we can't shift it further. So now again it became a max heap. Okay, and it will be look something like this. So this is the way we can delete a node from a max heap. For root I have shown how to do that. For any other node also the procedure is same. So we have to replace that node, or we have to delete this node, and we have to then replace that node with the last one. Then we have to shift that node into the proper position downwards. Okay, so now we will discuss what is the time complexity required to delete a node. So the worst case time complexity for deleting a node is O log n time. Why it is like that? Because the last node we replaced here, maximum it can go to the all the level down. Okay, suppose one node is there which can traverse from this root to the last level. Okay, so it has to traverse 3 level down to fit into the correct position. Okay, so what is this 3 level? How we are getting this level called 3, that is log of number of nodes, means log of n. So in this case, that is third level. So that's why the worst case time complexity for this deleting operation will be O log n. So I have beautifully explained this in the insert heap element part also. So in the icon you can see that. Okay. So now one more thing I want to discuss here, that is, so instead of placing it the 101 here, if we kept it here, then what will happen? Our delete operation is done. So the point I want to make here is, instead of placing the 101 here, so if we place it in the blank or empty position, which is outside of the heap area, the color difference you can see here. So it is outside of the heap area. So if we place here, then what will happen? So next time if I have to delete from root, then 37 will be deleted. Then that will come here. Then 27 will be deleted. That will come here. Then 18, then 16, then 8, then 3, then 2, then 1. And it will be placed like this. So what is actually that? What that array will become? It will be in an ascending order, sorted way. So that is the entry point of heap sort that we will come in the next video. Now you will discuss about the program delete from maxheap. So here in this main method, I have taken this maxheap, which is already constructed as a maxheap. So before going to that, I will discuss about two variables. One is heap size, another is heap capacity. So heap capacity means the length of the main array. Okay. And heap size means when we will start deleting, that time what will be the remaining effective length, that will be our heap size. Okay. So one is heap capacity, total length of the array. And heap size is the effective length, where actually only the nodes are present and other part is empty. So I am initializing this heap capacity as the array length, and heap size also will be the same. Okay. Then I am printing the heap once to show like what it was in previous. Then I am calling this delete from heap method. What I am doing there? So the node we have to delete is the root node. That is the 0th position. Okay. And the last node which will be replaced in this root part, that is heap size minus 1, that node, the last node. Then replacing that, and in this example, as I have discussed or I gave one hints before, that the deleted element or deleted node I am keeping in the last position. Okay. And then I am decreasing the heap size by 1. Effective length will be now reduced by 1. Okay. And then what we have to do? When I replace the last node with the root node, then we have to percolate down the root node to fit it in a proper position and again make it as a maxheap. So in the percolate down method, I am checking the like left child and right child, then I'm comparing. If it is greater than the parent, then I'm swapping this parent with the child, and I'm doing this operation a few times when actually it will be fit in the correct position. So this method is actually something similar as heapify method. You can see that heapify video. Okay. And this is simply a print heap method. Okay. And one more method I have written, that is print heap array. So it will just print the array, not like a tree format. Okay. So now we will run this program and see. So our goal is to first delete one element, that is the root node. So I will run this program, and we can see here, this is our max heap, and I have deleted the root node, that is 101, and then it will become this max heap. That is 37, 18, 27, 16, 3, 8, 1. Okay. So we can compare with our slide also. Okay. Then That will be our result, and our delete heap operation is done. So I want to take this program to a next level to do few observation. Okay. So now I am introducing one while loop here. So what this while loop will do? I want to delete the root node until the heap will come to an end. Okay. When the heap size is greater than 0, until that we will keep on deleting, and then we will see what will happen. Now I am running the program, and I can see now one by one what happened. So first 101 I deleted, then this is become this max heap, then I have to delete 37, then it will become like this, then I am deleting 27, then the heap structure is like this, and everywhere it is maintained the max heap property. Then I have deleted 18, then 16, then 8, then 3, then 2, then 1. Okay. So now you can see here this delete part 137, 27, 18, 16, 8, 3, 2, 1. So this is in an order, like it is in a descending order. So we have every time we have deleted the max value from that heap, because root is always the max value in that max heap. Okay. Now I will enable this print array. So what this print heap array? Now it will print the total array. Okay, how it looks like now. See, as I told earlier, whatever I am deleting, I am keeping it in the last position. Okay. So that's why after all this deletion, the array will be look like that. 1, 2, 3, 8, 16, 18. Totally it is in a ascending order. So this way actually we do the heap sort. Okay. So you can watch this part again, and you will definitely understand. So one by one, when I am deleting and keeping at the last position, okay, then first I deleted 101 and I kept it in the last position, then 37, then 27. Like that, it will come to an end, it will be a sorted array. Okay. So this is why actually heap sort is done. Still also I will make a complete video about it. Okay. And I will explain this heap size and heap capacity on that. Okay. And I will programming, I will put it in the description box, the GitHub link. Thanks for watching. We will see next, like how to do a heap sort.